So good morning, Lana. Welcome to our today's maths lesson. And in our previous lesson, we were discussing about reciprocals. I just want to mention something about the reciprocals that we discussed, where we said we are given a question like the reciprocal of 14 over 9. Get a reciprocal, you multiply by a number that when you multiply with this one gives you 1. That number is 29 or 14. So this becomes the reciprocal of 14 over 29, which is 29 or 14. I might have said that you don't simplify, but this one needs to be simplified. So after getting this, Lana, you divide, because our numerator is a bigger numerator compared to the denominator. So you divide 2 times, you get 28, you remain with 1. And so your answer will be 2, and the remainder 1 over 14. So that becomes your reciprocal. So that when you change this into mixed fraction, you still get 29 or 14. So whenever you get a numerator that is big than the denominator, you must simplify the simplest form. So today we are going to discuss about division of a fraction, our number by a fraction. And I'll give you examples so that you can understand exactly what we are doing. Like, for example, we have 2 divided by half. We are using, remember, we are using the reciprocals that we've just done in our previous lesson to be able to do this. So you pick 2, you put it over 1, then this sign will change to multiplication. The second part must also change, meaning that you are going to get the reciprocal of this, which is going to be 2 over 1. And this answer will give you 4 over 1, which is simply 4. So 2 divided by half is simply 4. That is example 1. So you can have a second example. And for example, you can be given something like 3 divided by a quarter. 3 divided by a quarter. The same case. Here, you first write these 3, put it over 1, so that tells a numerator and a denominator. Then this sign will change to multiplication, and because this sign has changed, we also need to change this number into reciprocal. The reciprocal of a quarter is, you take this, the denominator becomes a numerator in this case, and the numerator becomes a denominator, so it's 4 over 1. So that gives you 12 over 1, which is simply 12. Now, you will understand that in our first number here, we don't touch it. We touch the second number and the sign. The sign changes to multiplication, and this second number changes to its reciprocal. So we don't touch the first number. What we do to the first number, we just put it under 1, which does not change it. 2 over 1 is simply 2, because this one does not change this to become another different number. So that's what we are saying. We can do a third example. Now, that example, where, for example, you are given 12 divided by 3 quarters. 12 divided by 3 or 4. It's not always that you are going to have always the numerator of the fraction that you are dividing with 1. No. Sometimes it can change to be a number more than 1. So in case you are given such a question, Lana, what are you supposed to do? So the first number remains the way it is, 12, but you just put it over 1. That acquires a denominator. Then this sign will change to multiplication. That sign will change the second part of this question. So this goes up and this comes down to be 4 over 3. So from there, Lana, remember what I told you? We check either diagonally or vertically whether we can have a number that is having a common divisor between these two numbers. You realize that 3 and 12 is a common divisor, because 12 is a multiple of 3. So by 3, 1, divide by 3, you get 4. So 4 times 4 will give you 16. And so that question, you get an answer, 16. Maybe you do a word problem here. I'll write 6 bags of potato seeds. A question. 6 bags of potato seeds. Were divided among were divided among farmers. Question is, if each farmer got 1/6, if each farmer got 1/6 of a bag, how many farmers were there? How many farmers were there? So now when you're given a question like this, it's very, very important to understand the question and break it into some workable statements. We are told the bags are 6, so that is a key, a part of that question. Among farmers, and the farmers, each one of them got a 6. Then the question is, how many farmers? So in your question, the answer you get is all about farmers. So what are we dividing? The quantity is 6 bags. So 6 bags divided by a 6, because each farmer got a 6. Divided by a 6, you are likely to get the number of farmers that were there. So this is going to be 6 over 1, then multiply, and then this reciprocal of this is 6 over 1. You realize that you will get that 6 farmers. Those are the number of farmers that got the potato seeds. So Lana, if you're given a question of that nature, where you're dividing a whole number by a fraction, that is exactly what you do. Let me maybe do the last one before I give you some assignment for you to be able to complete back at home. You are told divide 5 by half. That should be E, 5 divided by half. So the same way, 5 over 1 times this change to multiplication, and this one becomes the reciprocal, which is 2 over 1. That will give you 10. So none of these questions are done in that way. So the idea of reciprocals, we're using them so that at this end, you can use them to be able to change this sign to multiplication, I change this second part into its reciprocal. So I want you to attempt questions in exercise 42. There are questions there. Questions number 1 to 4. And that will be found in page 60 of the primary maths. So I want you to do that. And in our next lesson, Lana, we are going to now divide a fraction by a whole number. So until next time, I want to wish you well. Have a very busy day back at home, and enjoy doing mathematics back at home. God bless you.